Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Learn More JavaScript on the ServiceNow platform. We're going to focus on a powerful tool for data analysis within ServiceNow. It's called GlideAggregate. This class is all about performing aggregate queries like counts, sums, averages, directly onto your database. So if you're ready to crunch some numbers, let's get started. Okay, anyways, GlideAggregate extends the functionality of GlideRecord, and it allows us to perform complex aggregate calculations without the need for multiple queries or additional JavaScript processing. It's pretty efficient, and it's optimized for large data sets. So in a lot of the ways where GlideRecord will be slow, GlideAggregate is the way you want to go if you're handling just numbers of things. All right, so before we dive into GlideAggregate, one of the ways to count records in ServiceNow is via GlideRecord. There is a method inside GlideRecord where you could say get row count. So in this example I have, I'm saying, hey, I want to create a new GlideRecord on the incident table. Show me all the highest priority incidents, run that query, and then tell me how many rows, so rows as in how many records are on that table, do you find? So if I run this script, count of high priority incidents, there's 27. That's a pretty simple query, and this instance is very small, so it runs almost instantaneously. But think about if you have thousands, 10,000s of records on sitting on one table, and you start running these queries, they get bigger and bigger and slower, and those can add up and slow your instance down whenever these queries run. So whenever you do things like want to count records or sum up the numbers on fields of records, you want to instead use GlideAggregate. So to use GlideAggregate, it's very similar to setup like GlideRecord. Instead of GlideRecord, you're going to say new GlideAggregate. Pretty straightforward. We're going to do it on the same table incident. We're basically recreating that script that we just saw, but in GlideAggregate, so I can show you how that works. Incident GA is at, and then we're going to add aggregate. So we're saying, hey, what do we want to do on this table? What kind of information are we are trying to extract from the database? We want to know a count of records. And then incident GA, we're going to, similarly to the GlideRecord, we want to add query. We're going to say priority is one. And then similarly to the GlideRecord, we want to make sure we say query. Okay, so now in the background, ServiceNow is figuring out how many records have the priority of one, and then it's doing a count of them for us. In GlideRecord, at this point, we would say something like incident dot next, so that we can iterate through all of the records that it found. But instead in GlideAggregate, the thing that we're saying, let's iterate through, it's actually all the different aggregates that we asked for. And then we're going to iterate through that. And so if I run a log statement here now, count of high priority incidents and say our incident.ga, or incident GA dot get aggregate. Notice that we have a add aggregate up here. Now we're saying get aggregate and count. And let's run that. And I am missing a parentheses. Let me go back. Hey, live debugging. Oh, here, I forgot a quotation mark actually for priority. Let me run that again. Oops. 27. Perfect. That's exactly the number I was expecting. We just went about it in the GlideAggregate way. Okay, so now let's get a little bit more complex. So say instead of just counting records, which is pretty straightforward, now we can do some more complex calculations. This is where GlideAggregate gets really awesome and useful. Say we want to sum up something instead of just counting it. So I'm still going to work on the incident table, but I'm going to change my aggregate to the sum of the reassignment count. And so now I'm saying, hey, go through all the incidents and then let me know how many times all of my incidents has been reassigned. And that might be good data to know for, a lot of our incidents are being reassigned. And what can we do to fix that? Let's change our query to reassignment count is not zero, just so that we can make sure it returns valid data. Notice that I've added this does not equal to it. Same thing like glide record, you can do that here. And then we're going to run the query as normal. And then on the log statement, let's make sure we log it properly and say total reassignments on incidents. And then we want to mimic what we're getting from our aggregates. And so instead of count, we're going to say sum, and then add a new parameter and say the sum of reassignment count. All right, let's run that. I don't think I missed a quotation mark anywhere this time. Perfect. So according to my instance, my incidents have been reassigned 26 times. Now, that would have been a lot harder for me to do via other scripts like GlideRecord. And GlideAggregate was able to do that pretty quickly for me. And then finally, I want to show you what you can do with being able to be more complex about how you sift through your data. For this example, I want to try to get the count of how many incidents are assigned to each category that I have in my instance. So let's go back and change this back to count to simplify things. So there's my one parameter of count. And my query, you know what? Let's get rid of the query. We don't need it. We want to get all the incidents and figure out all the categories for them. But what we want to do is add incident GA dot group by, and we'll say category. And now we're basically saying like, hey, I want to do a count, but based off of each category, not just all of them. And so let's start over on this logging statement and say the category of this aggregate is incident GA dot category, and then the count of this is incident GA dot get aggregate count. Okay, I think that will work, but let's go ahead and run script and see what happens. Okay, so I only have one row. And I know I have more categories inside of my instance, so there's a problem. Let me go back, and here is the problem. I left it as if. If we know we're going to go through multiple groupings, then we want to make it a loop. So I change it to while. And so this little statement here saying incident.next, it's going to keep going over and over again until all of my categories have been completed. And so let me run that script again, and you'll see it ran perfectly fine. So I only have 5 categories in this instance for the incident table, and it actually printed an extra record. That's the records that don't have a category set. So I have 4 records that don't have a category, and then 2 records with the database category, 10 records with the hardware category, etc. So you can see even in GlideAggregate, you're able to do a lot of cool stuff via subgroupings. You can do summing things up. You can count things based off of groupings. There's a lot of cool things you can do with it. And all of it runs much faster if you do it via GlideAggregate. So make sure you use this if you're doing any number crunching. Cool. There's an exercise that follows this video, so go ahead and check it out.